Page 144, question number 7. Prove that the area of an equilateral triangle described on one side of a square is equal to half the area of an equilateral triangle described on one of its diagonals. Very important question. Page 144, question number 7. Write the question, Nihal. Write the question, Nihal. Why you are so hesitant to write the question? You may think it is no need of writing a question, isn't it? Huh? If understand the question is half solved actually. So you write the question, understand the question always. That's why I'm giving time. I'm spending time to writing, understanding the question. Otherwise, I have no need to spend time on writing the question. No, I can directly move to answers. In mathematics, understanding question means half solved. Area of an equilateral triangle described on one side of a square is equal to half the area of the equilateral triangle described on one of its diagonals. Okay, now read the question, try to draw the figure. Prove that area of an equilateral triangle described on one side of a square. So we have a square. We have a square. And equilateral triangle described on one side of a square. So this, here we can draw an equilateral triangle. This is A, B, C, D. On one side of the square, we formed an equilateral triangle. And another equilateral triangle described on one of its diagonals. So AC, its diagonal. Another equilateral triangle is described on this diagonal. Two equilateral triangles, one of its base is AC, other base is BC, P and Q. Two equilateral triangles, one's base is AC and other equilateral triangle's base is BC. On one side, one equilateral triangle, and on diagonal another equilateral triangle. So we have ABCD square. Given is ABCD given. ABCD is a square. BCQ described on BCQ. Triangle BCQ described on BC. APC described on triangle APC. APC described on diagonal AC. Diagonal AC. What we have to prove? Prove that area of an equilateral triangle described on one side of the square. That is the equilateral triangle described on side is BCQ. So area BCQ is equal to half the area of the equilateral triangle described on one of its diagonal. Half area APC. This is the question we have to prove. This is given. To prove is area BCQ equal to half area APC. And see, these two are equilateral triangles. So they are dash. Fill it.
Similar.
Good. Two equilateral triangles are similar. So we can write proof. We will start. Proof. Since triangle BCQ and triangle APC are equilateral, we can write what? Triangle APC similar to triangle BCQ. They are similar because all the angles are equal. No, they are similar. Okay, so we can write area APC by area BCQ equal to square of the ratio of their sides. So we will take both the base of both. AC square by BC square. All other sides also, ratio of other two sides, square of ratios of other two sides are also equal. But we are taking only one. AC square by BC square. AC square by BC square. But all of you, look at the figure. This is a square, isn't it? All angles are 90. So ABC is a triangle. ABC is a triangle. ABC
right angle.
Triangle ABC is right angle. So AC square equal to what?
BC square plus AB square.
BC square plus AB square. Pythagoras theorem. But AB and BC are equal. They are equal because it's a square. All sides are equal. Okay. So AB and BC are equal. So we can 2BC square. AC square equal to 2BC square. That we can write. AC square is 2BC square. AC square is 2BC square divided by BC square. Cancel both the BC square. You will get area APC by area BC cube equal to 2. Cross multiplying area APC equal to 2 area BCQ. We have to prove BCQ. So area BCQ equal to 1 by 2 area not this question. It is very important question, repeatedly asked about question it is. Right, question 8.
And question 8 is that prove that not take the correct answer and justify.
Question number 8, ABC and BDE are two equilateral triangles. D is the midpoint of BC. Ratio of areas of triangles ABC and BDE is. Options are there. ABC and BD are two equilateral triangles. ABC and BDE are two equilateral triangles. ABC. Draw triangle ABC. Triangle ABC. ABC. And D is the midpoint of BC. ABC and BD are two equilateral triangles. D is the midpoint of BC. Ratio of areas of triangles ABC and BD. ABC and BD are equilateral triangles. So we can write what?
They are similar.
Yeah. AB, triangle ABC and triangle BDE are equilateral. So triangle ABC similar to triangle BDE. Triangle BDE. So we can write area ABC, area ABC by area BDE equal to AB square by BD square. AB square by BD square. But instead of AB, I'm writing BC square. Why? BC square by BD square. What is the reason? I wrote in
equal.
No, yes. They are equilateral now. So AB equal to BC. Equilateral triangle. And BC is 2BD. So 2BD the whole square by BD square. Because D is the midpoint of BC. So 4 BD square by BD square 4 by 1. So the ratio is ABC is to BDE equal to 4 is to 1. Correct option is C. C is the correct option. After that, write question number 9.
Thank you, Anish, for the board.
Today's date is 13 or 37. Raya, Rohan, Roshan, Vishnu, Lena, Lena, Navaneet, Maria, मेघनम. So what was the question? Question is, the sides of two similar triangles are in the ratio 4:9. Sides are in the ratio 4:9 or 4:9. Find the area of these, the areas of these triangles are in the ratio. What is the area of ratio of areas? Sides are in the ratio 4:9. So area of the triangles. Yes, area of triangles. Is equal to 4 square by 9 square, 36 by 81. So 16 by 81. So 16:81 is the correct answer.
Can you explain that once more? That problem.
Sides are in the ratio 4:9. So areas, their square. 4 square by 9 square. 16 by 81.
Oh, okay.
Dominic, are you okay now? Dominic, are you okay?
Ma'am, I'm fine.
Are you okay now?
Fine.
Tiredness is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, take rest and have good food, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What about your family members?
Ma'am, they all are negative. Negative. I am only positive.
Positive. Isn't it? Okay. Okay, children. So by this, our chapter triangles is over. Now, next period, we will start new chapter trigonometry, chapter 7 trigonometry. But we will do some more questions. Yesterday, Melita sent me some doubt questions that we will discuss now. Okay, Melita, are you there? Hello, Melita. Are you there? Yes, I can. Okay, children, Melita, we will discuss those questions now, okay? Okay, write the question. Children, all of you, write the question. The areas of two similar triangles, ABC and DEF, the area of two similar triangles, ABC and DEF, area of two similar triangles ABC and DEF are 144 centimeter square and 81 centimeter square. 81 centimeter square. If the largest side of ABC is, largest side of ABC is 36 centimeter, find the largest side of DEF. Find the largest side of DEF. Actually, it is a simple question because area is given. No, So we can write area of ABC by area of DEF is equal to largest side of side of ABC square square. Okay. Area of similar triangles equal to areas of their corresponding sides, area square of corresponding sides. Okay. So we can write 144 by 81 equal to, this is 36 square by largest side of DEF. Largest side of DEF. That is 12 square by 9 square equal to 6 square by largest side of DEF square.
Taking now we can also take the whole square from the 36 by the large
yes,
side
whole
of
square. Yes, whole square we can write. 6 by largest.
Ma'am, which question this is not seeing?
This is not from the textbook. Some she did some extra questions and she asked me to explain. The largest side of DEF is equal to 9 into 6 by 12. Find out. Sorry.
And do you have extra MCQ sample questions? MCQ?
Many are there. Many are there. With me, many questions are there. If you want, you can have to send me personally. Then I will send the questions. Okay, you can try. I can't give as a homework because if I gave many homework, you will complain. Ma'am is giving so many homework. That's why I'm not giving. This year, we have to face many complaints because you have many works and all. So if you need more, send me personal message. I will send.
Yeah.
Regularly, I give works. Along with, if you want more, regularly I will give. Did you try the questions that I have sent last day from polynomials? No, linear equations. I have sent 10 questions, 10 or 12 questions. Today also I will send. Next onwards, we will start with the triangles. Okay. Questions are many with all in our books. Questions are there side from the side also. If you type MCQ question from class 10, triangles, you can see many sites that are giving MCQ questions. Everything is there with you. Only thing you have to find time to do all this. Okay. Okay, is it clear, all of you? What was the answer? What was the answer? Answer? Naina. What was 36 square. See, children, sorry, this is 36 square. No, so this is not 6 square. 36 square, so it is 36. Sorry, it is not 6, it is 36. So 9 into 36. 36 square, no, largest side is 36. So its square is 36 square. So 9 into 36 divided by 12. So it is 27 centimeters. Okay. One more question. That question is, in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, XY parallel to BC, XY parallel to BC, XY parallel to BC, and it cuts AB at X, AC at Y, AC at Y. If BY bisects, it's a good question. If BY bisects angle XYZ, angle XYZ, then we have some options. The options are, options are AY equal to BY. Second option is BC equal to BY. Third option is AX equal to BX. All of you try for some time. Very good question, but it's very simple also. All of you try. Which option is correct?
What is a CAB? Yeah. And it is CAB. I don't understand that.
It cuts.
Okay.
Draw the figure. All of you draw the figure, then try. ABC is a triangle. ABC. XY parallel to BC. Line cuts AB at X, AC at Y. Then angle XYC. BY bisect XYC. XYC. BY. BY bisects XYC, which means these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. Then which option is correct? AY equal to BY or BC equal to BC equal to CY or AX equal to BX? All of you try. Any idea? Anybody?
Option C.
Option C. What is the reason? What is the reason? X, Y, and BC are parallel, but X is not the midpoint. X and Y are not the midpoint. It's not given. Only they are parallel. If one point, if either X or Y is midpoint, you are correct. If it is given, any one of X or Y is the midpoint, then you will get it. Other point also midpoint. But both X and Y are not the midpoints. Now, yes, Shania, say.
Ma'am, option A.
What is the reason?
Ma'am, Y is the midpoint.
No, Y is not. How can we know?
Ma'am, option B.
Option B, what is the reason?
An opposite angle.
Who is saying this?
Minha.
Minha, correct. Very good. Very good, Minha. Very good. Options B is the correct option because this angle and this angle are equal because BY dividing. And this also equal to these two angles because alternate interior angles. Okay. So in this triangle BYC, two angles are equal. So CY and BC are sides opposite to equal angles. CY and BC are the sides opposite to equal angles. Very good, Minha. Very good. So you can write the answer as angle X, Y, B equal to angle B, Y, C. It is given. Also, angle B, Y, C equal to angle, not B, Y, C. We will write angle X, Y, B equal to angle Y, B, C. These two, alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. So we can say angle Y, B, C equal to angle B, Y, C. These two are equal. So Y, C equal to, or C, Y, or B, C will be. B, C equal to C, Y. Reason, sides opposite to equal angles. Simple question, but you have to think in that way. Equal angles. Sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Okay, children. So next period we will begin with trigonometry. Okay. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Only for the